Mr. Reddick, Commissioner Reddick, I want to give you credit because you're certainly putting a brave face on in view of these dramatic cuts that the IRS has experienced over a period of years now. I mean, the numbers are breathtaking. The workforce having been reduced by 22% since 2010 is obviously undercut the IRS's daily operations in a significant way. And I want to salute the frontline workers at the IRS, the rank and file, who are really engaged in acts of heroism every day trying to lift up a caseload that I think is drowning them. So we have to get more resources to the IRS, and that has to be a number one priority for Congress, and I think it ought to be a priority of any administration. Unfortunately, we have not seen that from the Trump administration. When the IRS doesn't have enough resources, the fact of the matter is that the rich get richer, high-end tax cheats get away with not paying their taxes, fraudsters are able to get away with their schemes, and those who ought to be on the receiving end of severe and significant enforcement by the IRS are not. Meanwhile, those average Americans out there who play by the rules and look to the IRS to engage with them in a straightforward way and get them their refunds, make sure the earned income tax credit is processed, make sure that these economic payments that come from these stimulus measures we put in place are getting to them. They're the ones that are getting a short shrift here. So I think that's what's so offensive to many of us, is when the IRS doesn't have the resources that it should, it can't do what's necessary to enforce against those who are trying to evade their tax obligations on the one hand, and it can't provide the kind of service to everyday Americans who are playing by the rules on the other hand. Ms. Collins, can you talk a little bit more with us about how adequate funding around enforcement can actually pay huge dividends for the IRS and clamp down on the kinds of schemes and efforts to avoid tax payment that we know are going on out there every single day? Put some numbers behind that for us.
As we all know, that our U.S. tax system is a voluntary tax system, and we depend on people willing every year to sit down, fill out that form, and pay their appropriate amount of taxes. So I really think enforcement is a reward to those who voluntarily comply. And I think if the public does not see that the IRS is enforcing the laws, we're going to be at risk of losing people continuing to voluntarily comply.
Well, I appreciate that, because you know, sometimes those who want to attack the IRS on ideological grounds, they sort of say, you know, be afraid, the tax man cometh. But when the IRS is coming for those who aren't paying their taxes, aren't playing by the rules, that's the appropriate kind of enforcement. And the resources that you can garner if you do that enforcement well can then be redeployed again to help serve those taxpayers out there that are playing by the rules, are looking for that refund, are looking for the benefits that can come when we use the IRS to distribute important stimulus payments in the midst of a pandemic like we're doing right now. So that's the trade-off we see. And we have an obligation to make sure that the IRS is funded in a way that it can do its job and do its job on behalf of that broad set of Americans that rely on this agency to make sure resources get distributed in a fair fashion. So, Mr. Chairman, thank you for this hearing. It I think, emphasizes once again why we as a committee why Congress needs to work hard to get the resources to this agency, but also why we need leadership from the top. And I'm not talking about Commissioner Rettig right now. I'm talking about the President of the United States, who understands the valuable service that the IRS can provide. And with that, I yield back.